Appalachian Trail just got interesting. We got a little scrambly-wambly over here as Eric goes up. And down there, we just came from what is called the Lemon Squeezer. I had trouble going through it. What does that tell you? And there goes Eric. I'm going to follow him. Let's see what happens. We're running along the ridge. This is probably what Highview Terrace looked like before our house was there.
Hey,
what?
Found a dead body.
Cool.
Eat it?
I don't think we're at Donner Pass status yet.
Okay. Let's get hungry. We know it's here.
I feel like this is. Oh, that's a shelter. It's a shelter. Yeah, I'm not going in there.
Are you videoing?
Yeah.
Oh, so we have to find two spots. And we need two spots because we have two tents. And we have two tents because, well, Greg likes his space. Is that the nice way of saying it?
What's the nice way of saying?
Greg likes his space.
What did I do in 2000? No, in 2009. Biked across America. God. It makes up for it.
It doesn't. Okay, the time is evening, and the sun is almost totally away. That's my story.
And you're sticking to it. Here's Eric's,
my tent.
Here's Eric's half dome.
I'm gonna sleep on top of it right here. My plan is to get on top like that and,
and then over here, appearing out of the mist, we have Greg's quarter dome with his hat standing sentinel over it. And I'll turn off. And you could just, oh yeah, look at that. You could just barely make out the crepuscular scene.
No need to talk about sea life.
A rare sighting of an Eric Dinowitzi, the only one of its kind, extinct in the wild, except for this one. Appalachian Trail, Harriman State Park, gorgeous, wonderful, and since it's not summer yet, you can actually see pretty deep into the woods. The wind is making awesome noises in the trees, and it's really a great time of the season for hiking because it's not too cold, but there are still no leaves on the trees, so you can really see far and get the lay of the land. The sun is doing really cool things with the shadows. It's a great time of day. I don't know if you can see it, but that's the biggest city in America over there. Well, the United States of America. New York, it's right there. New York! It's right over there. I can't freaking believe. It's right over there.
Yeah. It's a stone's throw away. Quick, get a stone. Quick. It's a stick's throw. Okay, close enough. Nothing. I wasn't spying on you.
Why did the Greggy and Eric cross the road? Because the Appalachian Trail doesn't have an overpass over it. Passover.
Uh-huh.
Palisades Interstate Parkway.
Look, cars.
You first?
Luckily, the car is in one direction.
So, at a time.
didn't die yet. Hey, Greg! What?
All these people think we're so cool.
Every last one of them. They go, wow, there's the kid in stockings. He's so cool.
It's weird.
Okay.
Oh, do we register?
What? Barry Katz?
No. No way. No way. What? Melvin Vasquez?
Second time around.
A whole lot of people you know. The Perkins Memorial Tower on top of Bear Mountain and the Bear Mountain Bridge, part of it anyway, and right there
is me!
Right there is where that scenic overlook is, where I almost wiped out on the first day of my bike tour.
And me! We've almost completed a hike, but we can't say we've done it yet, because we're not at the car yet.
So, this is funny. This is an illustration of how cars are scary divine instruments. Those are the water towers that we passed this morning, and this is the Appalachian Trail. This morning we crossed this and went right there to continue on. That was like early this morning, and like maybe 20 minutes ago we got in the car and came back here. That's just a testament to how freaking slow walking is. As we continue on our journey,